Judy Garland, episode 19, air, take one.
From Television City in Hollywood, here's Judy!
I never will forget Jeanette McDonald. Just to think of her, it gives my heart a pang. I never will forget how that brave Jeanette just stood there in the ruins and sang. And sang. San Francisco, open your golden gate. You let nobody wait outside your door. San Francisco, here is your wandering one, saying I wander no more. Other places only make me love you best. Tell me you're the one in all the golden west. I'm coming home again, no more to roam again, never to roam again. San Francisco. Right when I arrive, I really come alive, and you will laugh to see me perpendicular. Just to watch it get dark from the top of the mark. There's Brooklyn Bridge, London Bridge, and the bridge of San Luis Rey. But the only bridge that's a real gone bridge is a bridge across the bay.
Really measure the pleasure you fellas bring. You know just how to swim.
We'll glitter and gleam. So just loan us your team.
So give us trumpets, trombones, your bass and drums and a piano player, maybe even your reed. And we'll swing baubles, bangles, bright, shiny beats.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a.
Bright, shiny beats.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a.
Bright, shiny beats. You do something to me, something that simply mystifies me. Oh, tell me, what can it be? You have the power to hypnotize me when I'm under your spell. Do do that, oh do that, you do so well. Cause you do something to me that nobody else can do. Be-a-wop, do do do, be-a-wop, bow. Do do do, do be do do, be-a-wop, do do do, be-a-wop, bow. Do 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 do, do be do be-a-wop, bow, bow. Ooh, ah, do be do be do, be-a-wop, do be do be do, be-a-wop. Do-bop, you do something to me. And when you shine those baby blues, I got to get my rockin' shoes. We're gonna make some swingin' news, because you and I will be together. You do something to me. And when you shine those baby blues, I got to get my rockin' shoes. We're gonna make some swingin' news, because you and I will be together. You do something to me. Because you and I will be together. Judy.
Yes, boys.
One small request, we would love to do one with you. Okay.
Sure, be my guest.
Many years ago, you could see a show, and the pretty songs made you weak in the knees. At a matinee, everyone would say, did you ever hear pretty lyrics like these?
Whispering while you cuddle near me. Whispering so no one can hear me. Each little whisper seems to cheer me, whispering that I love you.
That was long ago, now on every show, anytime you hear somebody sing, angels with the dough want the world to know that the very same kind of music can swing. Quiet, quiet, there really isn't any special need for a riot. Quiet, you never ever seem to lose your speed, can't you sigh it? Quiet. If I could only make your lips take heed, we could have a great time while we're swinging along. We might even hear the bells ringing along. Slowly, sweetly, if you and I are gonna have a romance, make it nicely, neatly. A love affair will stand a better chance, keep it softly, discreetly. And while the other couple start to dance, we'll take a flyer and light up the fire. And if you think you've seen what we really mean, and the little song starts you tapping your feet, we would like to say there's another way. Here is how the lyrical twain can meet.
Whispering while you cuddle near me. Whispering so no one can hear.
Never ever seem to lose your speed, can't you sigh?
Each little whisper seems to cheer me. I know it's true, there's no one
here.
You're whispering why you never leave.
You and I are gonna have romance, make it nice.
Whispering so you'll never grieve.
A love of hills and a better chance, keep it soft.
Whisper and say that you believe. Whispering that I love you.
your show tonight? Is it someone? Très magnifique.
Every little breeze seems to whisper Louis. Birds in the trees seem to whisper Louis. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Louis Jourdan.
Hi, Judy. Come on, fellas, come on.
Ring, jingle-ing-a-ling, ring, jingle-ing-a-ling, baubles, bangles, bright, shiny beads, jingle-ing-a-ling, baubles, bangles, bright, shiny beads, sparkles, spangles, your heart will sing, jingle-ing-a-ling, wearing baubles, bangles, and beads,
your glitter and dream.
Wait just a minute. Wait a minute, Louis. What's the matter?
Cool. Don't you like my number?
Well, I like it, but it isn't just what we expected. We expected something a little more romantic.
A little more romantic, that's right. It's always the same story. I can never do what I want. I can never do what I want.
What do you want to do?
I want to swing it, baby. I want to swing it. I want a kind leg. You know, kind of get cool, you know, and, you know, just go, baby, go. That's what I want. I want to go.
Why, Louis.
Yeah, just go.
Louis, if you swing, you'll destroy your image.
Oh, I don't care about that.
Well, but the Kirby Stone Quartet has just swung.
I don't care about
that. Well, it'll be anticlimactic.
I don't
besides
care
that,
about
if you
that.
Swing, we won't pay you.
Oh, I care about yes. that. Judy, yes. I changed my mind.
Okay.
Anything you want from me, you will have. You
oh,
know that.
Yes.
All right. Come on, cool it, fellas. Cool it, huh? All right. Bye.
Now, as I said before, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Louis Jourdan.
When I was a boy, my mother often said to me, get married, boy, and see how happy you will be. I have looked all over, but no one I can find like the girl I have in mind. I want a girl just like the girl that married dear old Dad. She was a pearl and the only girl that Daddy ever had. A good old-fashioned girl with heart so true, one who loves nobody else but you. I want a girl just like the girl that married dear old Dad. A good old-fashioned girl heart so true, one who loves nobody else but you.
I want a girl just like the girl that married
moon's gone, the shades are down. Paris is only a lonely town, lonely. When love's a laugh and you're the clown, Paris is only a lonely town, dreary. Town's a weary merry-go-round and round and round. The chestnut, the willow, the colors of your trillo turn to gray-gray hues. The band bridge is a bridge of sighs. River, river, won't you be my lover? Don't turn me down. For was true. I, of course, replied, something here inside cannot be denied. They said, someday you'll find all who love are blind. When your heart's on fire, you must realize smoke gets in your eyes. So I chaffed Boston, and I gaily laughed to think they could doubt my love. Yet today, my love has flown away. I am without my love. Now laughing friends deride tears I cannot hide. So I smile and say, when a lovely flame dies, smoke gets in your eyes. So I chat and I gaily laughed to think they could doubt my love. Yet today my love has flown away. I am without my love. Laughing friends cry tears I cannot hide. So I smile and say, when a lovely flame dies, smoke gets in your
half of the Judy Garland Show has been brought to you by Bentley and James, makers of contact for all day, all night relief from head cold congestion. The second half of the Judy Garland Show is brought to you by General Mills, home of Betty Crocker products, new gold medal Wonder Flower, and the Big G Goodness Cereal.
You know, we've had some people on our show since we started, and you've seen them and enjoyed them every week, but somehow I've never gotten around to introducing them to you, so I'm going to do that tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the Wally Siebert Dancers. DJ Mattis and Gary Mantia. Nancy Martin and Michael Stewart. Sharon Shaw and Norman Edwards.
Shall we fly? Shall we dance? Shall we dance? Say goodnight and mean goodbye. Or perchance, when the last little star has left the sky, shall we still be together with our arms around each other? And shall you be my new romance? On the clear understanding that this kind of thank you.
is great, kids.
Now that marvelous man who makes marvelous movies of marvelous people. What am I so out of breath for? I wasn't in the number. Mr. Ken Murray.
With a little movie camera and a brand new car. Well, he had a lot of fun with this little movie camera, cause this funny man was a movie fan. So he never, no, he never stopped grinding away, taking pictures of the stars and working at play. And there's just as much fun to run today. Hey, everybody, over to Ken Murray's house for home movies. Home movies. Home movies of the movie stars.
Judy, have I got some film for you tonight.
Really? What is it?
I am not kidding you. Among other things, I brought something that you're really going to get a kick out of.
Tell me.
I have the screen test of one of the biggest movie stars in the entire motion picture history. A man is really a legend. And I'm not going to tell you who it is. You're going to have to watch. Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you something. You know, on lots of shows, people come out and they say, well, I haven't met you before, I haven't heard this joke, and you have the feeling it was rehearsed. But in this case, it's absolutely true. And how it happened was that when Judy invited me on her show, she said...
I didn't want to see them because I wanted to be surprised.
That's right. I said, what do you want me to bring down? You said, just bring home movies. I want to be surprised. Now, the first part of this film was taken in 1927. Uh-huh. And you know, you found out yourself that when people come from out of town, the one thing they want to do is see inside of a movie studio.
Yes, right.
Isn't that right? Right. Well, I felt the same way when I got here in 1927. And this first shot is the first movie set that I ever was on. Here it is. That's John Barrymore and Dolores Costello.
How marvelous. What movie is that?
That's, I don't know, The Sea Beast or something. Look at the fellow playing the violin.
Not The Sea Beast.
Yeah, and the director. Listen, the musician looks like he parted his hair with a violin bow.
Who's that lady?
Yeah, that's Dolores Costello.
Oh.
And the director was talking to him, you know, he'd pick up the
mat. Was that the violin player? Was he underscoring the...
Yeah, no, mood music. Just playing.
Was he in the scene?
No, he wasn't in the scene. He's just playing it off screen. You know, he says, kiss her, John, kiss her, see?
And you then don't even have any titles.
Yeah, he says, cut, cut. He said, Mr. Barrymore, it's time for lunch. Afterwards, at lunchtime, I went outside. There I am.
Oh, he's
24
well-dressed.
Years old.
My goodness.
Yeah, and I got a shot of John Barrymore coming out to lunch. Here it is. This is. He was handsome. Look at this.
Yes, he was.
Wasn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, still good looking under these standards, would you say?
Oh, under any standards.
Any standards at all. Now, that was the first movie set. Now, 2 years later, I came to RKO Studios to work in the first picture that they made there. Look at the difference in the lights. And the cameras had blimps on them.
I haven't been in movies that long.
Yeah. They had sound trucks on the street. You know something funny? I made up very early in the morning. I have a shot of myself coming out of my dressing room. Here I am.
Is that you? That's Cary Grant. My goodness.
Well, there I am.
There you are.
There is a resemblance.
Not really, when you think of it.
Well, we both had tails out there. Look at that. Buddy Rogers.
Yes.
Remember Buddy? He was America's boyfriend at that time. And John Bowles was making Rio Rita. There's John Bowles with Governor Ralph of California.
That is John Bowles?
Yes, and they had two fellas from New York, Wheeler and Woolsey. Remember?
Oh, yes.
Bert Wheeler and Robert Woolsey.
They were marvelous.
RKO put them in the driver's seat. You can see that. And right next door, the biggest thing on the lot, though, at that moment, was Rudy Vallee. Yeah. There he is, Rudy Vallee.
He's got the same hair he has now?
Yeah.
So is she.
Yeah. That's Sally Blaine, that's Loretta Young's sister.
Oh, yeah.
Now watch as this camera pans over and watch this great lady making her first TV, first talking.
That's Marie
Dressler.
Marie Dressler.
Yeah, wait to see this look she gives this woman, look. And there she is kidding. What does she want?
I love that hat.
Yeah.
Heavenly
hat. Here is the last. Here's the last scene of the picture, and I kept it in because they watch the look on Sally Blaine's face. Now, mind, she has just kissed the number one lover of the world at that moment. You know. Now watch her face. much.
Oh! Right.
And this was right next door, Paramount Studio, and Mary Pickford came over to see, to welcome Bing Crosby, who was...
Is she driving?
Yeah, she's driving, yes. That was one of those new compact cars in those days.
Well, a little job.
Yes, and she came in. Bing Crosby was making his first picture.
Who's that with her?
I don't know. I never got his name.
Is he driving?
Here's Bing. Here's Bing coming out to meet... Look at... When the blue of the night means the gold of the curls.
Yeah. Yeah,
isn't that nice? Interesting. That was the first
time
they ever met.
Diffused.
They were making a lot of pictures on the lot at that time. There's Constance Bennett and Gilbert Rowland. And there's Maurice Chevalier. Now, this was the
set one?
Of... That's Baby Leroy with him.
Baby Leroy?
Yeah.
Right?
He is now 6'2".
Yes.
Incidentally, it was 25 years before I got another shot on a set with Chevalier. This was taken over in Gigi. Look at
that. There's Louis.
There's our friend. This was taken over in... Now, that's the original Maxine set. And the fellow by the camera there... has the distinction of being the only cinematographer that won 4 Academy Awards and 10 nominations. And you know him, Joe Ruttenberg.
Oh, my, yes.
He made Lily Mars with
you.
Yes,
he did.
I believe. And I want to tell you, taking pictures on that set was really murder. Oh, I tell you. The assistant, there. There's Chevalier. There's Zsa Zsa. And there's our friend Louis Jourdan over there.
Yes.
It was awful trying to get set. Now, here's some more shots taken 30 years ago. He had his arm in a sling and he got hurt. There's Alison Skipworth. And there's Richard Arlen.
Who's that little fellow? The one who broke Maurice's arm.
And that's Marie Dressler. First time, or rather, Marie Dressler.
Marie Dressler. Great.
Marlene Dietrich.
I think so.
And now here comes the surprise for you. I have Maurice Chevalier's test. The first time that he ever sang Louis. Here it is.
Test. Chevalier, take one.
Every little breeze seems to whisper Louise. Birds in the trees seem to whisper Louise. Each little rose tells me it knows I love you. I love you. Every little beat that I feel in my heart seems to repeat what I felt at the start. Each little sigh tells me that I adore you. Louis, just to see and hear you is joy I never knew. But to be so near you thrills me through and through. Anyone can see why I wanted your kiss. It has to be, but the wonder is this. Can it be true someone like you could love me?
Louis!
Ah, Judy. This is the moment I've been waiting for. A duet with you. See, actually, I don't really sing, but singing with you is going to make me think I do.
Oh, thank you, Louis. But we are going to sing together.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yes.
Wonderful. Now, what are we going to sing? Are we going to sing something special, or perhaps, what about... what is this?
Well, these are all a bunch of big, cuddly, soft, stuffed animals, and I hope you don't mind.
But this is wonderful, but what are they going to do? Are they going to sing with us?
Oh, Louis. How old is your son?
My son?
Yes.
12? Why?
Well, I have a little boy who's 8 and a little girl who's 11, so I thought maybe we'd sing some songs for our children, if that's all right.
Oh, that's wonderful. I love that. Now, Judy, could you please sing my son's favorite song?
Well, I think I'll try it.
It's a surprise, huh?
Yeah. Never done it before, but I'll try now.
You do it.
Right. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man.
Doop, doop.
I'm Popeye the Sailor Man.
Doop, doop.
I fight to the finish, cause I eats me spinach. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man.
Doop, doop. Now, this is a lot of fun, but Judy, shouldn't you be singing something in a more romantic vein?
Well, that song, olive oil, that's very romantic.
That's
you
true,
know.
That's true, that's true. Olive oil and Popeye, the greatest romantic couple of the century. Now, there is a song which is a favorite in my house.
Yes.
The greatest show in town is Huckleberry Hound for all you guys and gals. The biggest clown in town is Huckleberry Hound with all his cartoon pals. It's Huckleberry fun, it is for everyone. So come on, gather round and get yourself all set. Tune up your TV set for Huckleberry Hound.
When you get in trouble and you don't know what to do, give a little whistle, give a little whistle. When you meet temptation and the urge is very strong, give a little whistle, give a little whistle.
Just a little squeak, pucker up and blow. And if your whistle's weak, yell, Jiminy Cricket.
Take the straight and narrow path, and if you start to slide,
give a little whistle, give a little whistle.
And always let your conscience be your guide. I can't whistle. Would mind too much if I asked you to sing Gigi. I love the way you do that.
Judy, Gigi is very nice, but there is another song about a little girl which I think will be a little more familiar with the children. Little Lulu, little Lulu, with freckles on your chin, always in and out of trouble, but mostly always in, using daddy's necktie for the tail of your kite, using mommy's lipstick for the letters you write. Though the clock says 7:30, it's really after 10. Looks like Lulu's been repairing it again. Though you're wild as any Zulu, and you're just as hard to tame, little Lulu, I love you, Lou, just the same, the same. Little Lulu, I love you, Lou, just the same.
Upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. Like a bolt out of the blue, fate steps in and sees you through. When you wish upon a star, your dreams come.
Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? Big bad wolf, big bad wolf. Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? Tra la 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 la.
Mr. Bluebird's on my shoulder. It's the truth, it's actual.
Everything is satisfactual.
Zippity doo dah, zippity yay. My oh my, what a wonderful day. Plenty of sunshine headed my way. Zippity doo dah, zippity yay. Someday my prince will come. Someday I'll find my love, and how thrilling that moment will be when the prince of my dreams comes to me.
a kiss or two, though he's far away. My love someday will come when my dreams come true. Singing Irving Berlin's songs so much, and so many of them that he's written are so lovely that I'd like to do one tonight that I wish I had done in the Carnegie Hall album. That album, by the way, did sell a million copies, and it's... I'm not kidding. It did, and I got my first gold record from it, and you've got to look out for them because they're terrible on your needle. Just like that joke. Let's do Irving's song. What'll I do when you are far away and I am blue? What'll I do? What'll I do when I am wondering how you feel just now? What'll I do? What'll I do with just a photograph to tell my troubles to? When I'm alone with only dreams of you that won't come. What'll I do? A few weeks ago, we closed the show with a marvelous song called The Battle Hymn of the Republic, and ever since then, we got so many marvelous letters and telegrams. We've been trying to think of some song to take the place of the Battle Hymn of the Republic, but there is no song to take the place of the Battle Hymn of the Republic, so I think we should just do the same one again.
Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He hath loosed his fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. Trumpet that shall never call retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of men before his judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer him. Be jubilant, my feet. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory. Transfigures you and me. As he died to make men holy, let us die to make men free. While God is marching on.
We're gonna make it. next on the show tonight? Is it someone? Pray magnifique.
Every little breeze seems to whisper Louis. Birds in the trees seem to whisper Louis. Mr. Louis Jourdan, ladies and gentlemen.
Come on, fellows, come on. Come on.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a bobble.
No, no.
Bobble?
Okay, hold on.
Speakers off. Speakers off.
No.
Speaker went off.
Speakers off.
Speakers, those speakers off.
Yeah.
I can hear it in his eyes.
Damn, I set my bubble.
We must be.
He was alone.
And yeah, I was all by myself.